Today we're going to be sharing with you our FastPass selections for Animal Kingdom theme park.
Animal Kingdom is another park that has the tier system where you have a few rides that are probably the more popular rides that are in tier one, and then kind of the rest of them fall out into tier two. You get one selection in your fast passes in the tier one rides and then two more in tier two. So
Yep, and this is new to Animal Kingdom. Animal Kingdom has not had a tier system in the past. This was exclusively at Hollywood Studios and Epcot.
They just put this in with Avatar.
Right. When Avatar opened in May this year, then Animal Kingdom switched to the tier system as well. So they've left all of the other rides from the park in tier two category. So even all of your favorites from before, you're gonna be able to go on them. So I think this was a really smart way to handle this.
Well, it's a way not to fast pass both Pandora rides and everything else.
Huh? Yeah, so there's two new rides at Animal Kingdom, and these are both in Pandora, which is the world of Avatar. It's the new land at Animal Kingdom. And both of these are going to be in the tier one category. So you can only choose one of the two new rides. So why don't you tell them what our pick would be?
Avatar Flight of Passage. We have not been down there since Pandora opened up. So this is what we've heard previously, is that this is probably the more popular ride. Mm-hmm. So that's what we're gonna put on here for tier one Fastpass.
Yes, and I've been checking the wait times regularly. I have the My Disney Experience app on my phone, and I do recommend that you download this prior to going on vacation, and you can kind of get an idea for yourself like what the wait times are. Because the Flight of Passage has had, I think when it first opened, 4 to 5 hour wait times. And then on the lower end, 90 minutes up to 2 hours. So that's about...
That's a long wait still. I mean,
that's about as short as the line gets. So that's why we chose this one. It's because there are high wait times still. It's a brand new ride. And it is the more popular of the two rides. It's more of a thrill seeker's ride. And then the other one on that list to choose from would be the Navi River Journey. And this one looks beautiful. It looks amazing. I can't wait to see it. It's not the one I would fast pass unless I could not get a fast pass for the Flight of Passage ride.
Typically has shorter wait times.
Yeah, and that's what I've been seeing, is maybe 45 minutes, and I would wait that because we've never done it before. All right, so that's what we would choose in tier one, is the Flight of Passage. And in tier two, you have the rest of your rides from Animal Kingdom and shows.
Everything else that we all know that's not Pandora is in tier two.
They're all in tier two. So what would you choose for our second Fastpass choice?
For me, I would choose a safari. Mm-hmm. I mean, it may be, every time I've been there, that seems to be the longest wait. It's also the funnest ride. Mm-hmm. I mean, the kids really seem to like it. It's the longest ride, you know, where you get to get on the bus and you're on there for 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Something like that.
We're also a homeschooling family, so this is the most educational of the rides at Disney World, I think.
Yeah.
I think the kids get a lot out of this one. The cast members that drive the safari trucks on this are very knowledgeable. I feel like they actually teach you a lot when you're on this safari. So it's a fun one. So I definitely would have that.
Yeah.
And the nice thing too is that you can take
babies. You can take babies. It always just seems to be a really long wait too. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you don't fast pass it, it seems to be 45 minutes or an hour.
We've actually waited much longer. I've seen really long lines for that in the past. It seems like it slowed down.
I don't know
some.
If since Pandora got there, it might have calmed down a little.
But so yeah, that's why we would fast pass that one.
Yep.
And then the third fast pass that I would choose, depending on height, is Expedition Everest. And this one is simply because it's a thrill seekers ride. It is a fun roller coaster. You get to go backwards on this roller coaster. You get to see the Yeti. I love this one, and on the last trip, we actually got to do this one at night for the first time, and I think I love that ride so much more because we did it at night. It really was more exciting.
I just remember Adeline not getting to go on it.
She was really sad. She was crushed because
she missed
43 inches, and you have to be 44. So, those would be what we would choose at Animal Kingdom. Flight of Passage, number one. If you cannot book Flight of Passage, then definitely book the Navi River Journey. But Flight of Passage would be our number one choice in the category one for our Fast Pass. And then in the second category, I would choose Expedition Everest. and Kilimanjaro safaris. And these are because they see the longest wait times. So besides those, you have the Finding Nemo musical is a show, Flights of Wonder is a show, It's Tough to Be a Bug is a show, and Rivers of Light is a show. So because these are all shows, they do have much more room for seating. With the exception of Rivers of Light, because it is a newer show, I would recommend doing a dinner package at either Tusker House or Tiffin's. It's actually called the Rivers of Light Dinner Package. So it would include, with your dinner, you'd actually get seating to this show time. So I think it's the first showing that you'd get to go to. So that's how I would get around doing Rivers of Light without using my FastPass, especially since you are holding that FastPass till the end of the day. So, and we'll talk more about that in the tip video on why you don't want to hold your FastPass till the end of the day. Mm-hmm. So yes, a lot of times for shows, we just don't like to use our FastPasses. There's plenty of room and everybody does end up going in at the same time anyway. Let's see, Kali River Rapids is one that it is
we
fun.
We went on it last time for the first time, I think, yeah. And did not wait very long.
We didn't wait long. It's not a long wait time. I also don't enjoy getting wet at Disney World. We brought a change of clothes with us just in case, and so we were dragging bags around with us, and it wasn't...
And big old rain... Remember we wore big old rain ponchos on the ride.
Well, because it's one of those rides where you just don't know. You're either going to get completely drenched or get two drops of water on you. There's somebody on the ride... There's usually one side of that ride that gets just completely soaked, and you don't know if that's going to be you or not. And I don't like walking around soaking wet the rest of the day, personally. So to me, this is one that either, you know, stand by or maybe don't do this ride altogether. But and then Primeval World is another choice on the Fast Pass on the tier 2 category, and this is one that it's again maybe a 15-minute wait for it at the most. And this is one that if you are motion sick, probably you don't want to do this
and
one
anyway.
And it
has whirl in the title.
Yeah.
That's a second thought right there.
Whirl, hurl.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then besides that, you also have a meet and greet with Disney pals. And I believe this is Rusty and Doug pretty much every time that we've gone. It's always Rusty and Doug. And again, it's just not
a
very
long
wait.
Yeah.
And then lastly, we also have Dinosaur. And I love Dinosaur. Mm-hmm. But quite honestly, it's usually about a 10 minute wait.
Yeah.
So it's not, to me, it's not one to necessarily
I think it's one of those that you get, you're on a Jeep and there's probably four or five rows of four or five people and they're constantly going.
So I mean,
you're putting out 25 people every 30 to 60 seconds.
Yeah, and
it's just not a long line.
It's kind of in a weird little corner of the park too, where it's not really overcrowded in that section. I don't know if people don't know it's there or if they're just, I don't really know, but it just doesn't seem like.
It's not a long wait.
No, it isn't. So those are our top FastPass selections at Animal Kingdom. We hope that you found this video useful to you today in planning your Disney World vacation. If you'd like to see more videos like the one you saw today, please give this video a thumbs up so that we know that you enjoyed it. And if you haven't subscribed already, please consider subscribing. Thank you guys all so much for watching today. Have a great day. Besides the fact that it is like so much fun.
It's awesome.
It is so much fun. And everyone makes a mad dash for this ride as soon as they enter the park.